Justice Department to help overturn the election.
What do you make of the fact that, I mean, some of the key architects of the attempts to overthrow the election have been rewarded with more power? The current Speaker of the House was one of the main people, if not the main person, pushing the big lie, trying to get people to sign on to overthrow the election. Scott Perry, who sought a pardon, according to Cassidy Hutchinson. None of these people have paid a price. The people who've paid a price are people like Liz Cheney, who's out of power and out of office.
Well, sadly, that's exactly right. And indeed, when you look at the effort to replace McCarthy, Thomas Emmer, who was eminently qualified, was essentially disqualified because he wasn't a proponent of the big lie. And what we found out in that speakership fight was the prerequisite to being the leader of the Republican Party in Congress is you must be willing to lie for Donald Trump.
Yeah.
You must be willing to undermine our democracy. If you're not, you're not qualified to run this conference. And so we did end up with a speaker who was very involved in the litigation to overturn the election. And we still have a Judiciary Committee chairman who, as you point out, ignored subpoenas of the January 6th committee and was also one of the architects in the House of trying to overturn the election. The only ones who did pay a political price were Liz Cheney, Adam Kinzinger, those that lived up to their oath of office. And I think history will reflect very well on them. But it has been a bitter shock to me, and I think many others, that the Liz and Adams have been so few in number that the vast, vast majority of Republicans cared far more about holding their office than they ever did about the oath of office or anything else.
I love that you presume that history will still be legal to tell. So I'm going to hold on to that hope.